For the past couple of days, I've been experimenting with Bowden cables for robotics. So what is a Bowden cable? Wikipedia defines it as, a Bowden cable is a type of flexible cable used to transmit mechanical force or energy by the movement of an inner cable relative to a hollow outer cable housing. The housing is generally of composite construction, consisting of an inner lining, a longitudinally incompressible layer, such as a helical winding or a sheaf of steel wire, and a protective outer covering. In fewer words, it's a string or cable within a tube. Because this tubing can't change length, the amount of cable in the tube always remains constant. This is important because no matter how much you bend or twist the tubing, it will not affect the cable on either end of the tube. Pulling or pushing on the cable on one side will always result in the exact same motion on the other end, regardless of how much the tubing is twisted or bent. So why is this so helpful? To answer this, let's look at three places where it is used. The first place that it is used is in 3D printers, specifically 3D printers with Bowden extruders.
Oh, so that's where the name comes from.
Oh yeah, how about that? In this case, the filament is used as the cable and some PTFE is used as the tubing. It is used this way to accurately extrude the right amount of filament when the extrusion motor is a decent distance from the hot end, where the filament is laid down onto the bed. The next place it is used is in bikes. Bowden cables were actually first invented for use on bikes. Bikes have many Bowden cables on them, as they are used to control the brakes and derailleurs.
Well, what about hydraulic brakes?
That's not what we're talking about, annoying version of me. The cables run from the handlebars to the derailleurs and brakes on the bike. This is an example of very crucial functionality. A biker's life depends on the operation of the brakes, and Bowden cables working exactly as expected, allowing the precise transfer of energy through cables that bend all around. A final place where Bowden cables are found is in lawnmowers.
Like you ever mow the lawn.
Dang, you're annoying. Can you go away, please? In a lawnmower, the dead man switch is controlled by a Bowden cable attaching to the lever on the handle and somewhere inside the mechanics. It is important this works here so that a killer lawnmower doesn't go on the run when you let go of it.
A killer lawnmower? Is that really the best joke you have?
Why are you still here? I just told you to get out of here. So let's finally look at my experiments. Just look at all those parts. All fails, some not even from this project. I tested the transfer of rotation from a servo to a pulley using two Bowden cables. Two are required because a pulley goes forwards and backwards. I've seen people use springs for the return direction instead of a second Bowden cable, but a spring comes with a whole new set of problems, like obtaining and making the springs, increased strain on the servo to hold the spring, and the spring doesn't have any holding tension like a servo would. For the tubing, I used this really cheap PTFE 1mm outer diameter and 0.5mm inner diameter tubing from eBay. It was about $12 for 20 meters. For the cable inside, I'm using some fishing line I found in the garage. It's very important for accuracy that the inner diameter of the tubing is as close as possible to the diameter of the control wire. The joints where tubing joins with the plastic parts have little stops built in so that the tubing cannot be pulled straight through instead of the control wire. The mechanism attached to the servo is designed to be the same width as the servo so that many servos can be mounted right next to each other to make a big servo block. The wire on the pulley side is attached with a very simple knot, and the wire on the servo side is attached by a screw. I used a screw for ease of tensioning the wire. The fishing line must be kept at tension for the pulley to accurately move with the servo. By using the really cheap fishing line I found in the garage, I do have a slight problem with stretching. It is very easy to push the pulley end, or even stop it completely. In a way, this is nice because it gives a form of compliance, where the joint can be pushed on or stopped without breaking it, but it also creates a problem because of how weak it is on such a short cable. I'm worried about a longer run creating an even weaker joint because the string is more length to stretch over.
Who would have guessed a random fishing line isn't good enough for robotics?
What is your problem, mate?
I can't do it, it's just so stupid.
Moving the potentiometer that the servo used to check positions from the final output gear to the joint would help with accuracy. But what worries me is that if something blocks the joint and the potentiometer never reaches what the servo expects, the motor will keep trying to spin until it stalls. Then when the block is removed, the joint will spring back to an extreme position and the servo will have to correct itself. Now, how could this be used in an animatronic? I see this being most useful in a small scale, low load joint where there isn't enough room to fit a servo. Being able to use Bowden cables will allow me to build smaller and more intricate animatronics. Another place where the Bowden effect is used in animatronics is in tail or tentacle mechanisms, but that's a whole nother video. That's all I have for now. Soon we will look at how an animatronic tail works and how the Bowden effect is used within it. Make sure you are subscribed so that you are updated when new videos are released.